Welcome to the 2016 commencement celebration of Aspen Valley High School and Academy Online High School. My name is Eli Tercero.
And my name is Adriana Shear.
Please stand, remove your hats, and join us in reciting the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Three, two, one. We would like... Please be seated. We would like to introduce Mr. George Stone, principal of Aspen Valley High School.
It's my pleasure to welcome all of you to Aspen Valley and Academy Online's 2016 commencement. Congratulations to you, our seniors. I would like to open our ceremony today with a story that I believe best characterizes you, our graduating class of 2016. This comes from The Velveteen Rabbit by Marjorie Williams. The skin horse had lived longer in the nursery than any of the others. He was so old that his brown coat was bald in patches and showed the seams underneath, and most of the hairs in his tail had been pulled out to string bead necklaces. He was wise, for he had seen a long succession of mechanical toys arrive and boast and swagger, and by, break their mainsprings and pass away. And he knew that they were only toys and would never turn into anything else. For nursery magic is a very strange and wonderful thing, and only those playthings that are old and wise and experienced, like the skin horse, understand all about it. "What is real?" asked the rabbit one day when they were lying side by side near the nursery fender before Nana came in to tidy the room. "Does it mean having things that buzz inside you and a stick-out handle?" "Real isn't how you're made," said the skin horse. "It's a thing that happens to you. When a child loves you for a long, long time, not just to play with, but really loves you, then you become real." "Does it hurt?" asked the rabbit. "Sometimes," said the skin horse, for he was always truthful. "But when you're real, you don't mind being hurt." "Does it happen all at once, like being wound up?" he asked, "or bit by bit?" "It doesn't happen all at once," said the skin horse. "You become. It takes a long time. That's why it doesn't happen often to people who break easily or have sharp edges or need to be carefully kept. Generally, by the time you are real, most of your hair has been loved off and your eyes drop out and you get loose in the joints and very shabby. Because these things don't matter at all. Because once you're real, you can't be ugly, except to people who don't understand." "I suppose you're real," said the rabbit, and then he wished he hadn't said it, for he thought the skin horse might be sensitive, but the skin horse only smiled. "The boy's uncle made me real," he said. "That was a great many years ago, but once you're real, you can't become unreal again. It lasts for always. I look at your faces and the faces of your classmates among the rest of the student body, and I can instantly call to mind a time when each and every one of you helped a classmate along the journey to becoming real. I've seen you hurt, and I've seen you heal. I've seen you take turns loving the rough edges off of one another. That's how it is here at Aspen Valley. We're family. We're each other's velveteen rabbits. We help each other through the process of becoming real. To our graduates, I want to say thank you. We're proud of what you are making of yourselves, and we're grateful for what you have contributed to Aspen Valley during your time here. Joining us today in support of our graduates are the District 20 Board of Education, representatives from District 20 Administration, Mr. Glenn Strebe representing the District 20 Education Foundation, the staff of Aspen Valley High School, and the staff of Academy Online High School and NOP. I would also like to recognize, and welcome some of our alumni. You never really leave Aspen Valley. And so in our audience today, and I'd like you to be recognized, we have Janine Krall. Mrs. Megan, you guys know her as McCormick Schaefer. I believe I saw Loretta Rutledge come in. Loretta, are you here? I saw that hand waving. Did I miss anyone else back there? Anybody else slip in? And I finally want to recognize my mother. I've been principal at Aspen Valley for, I think it's 12 years now. I'm like the Velveteen Rabbit. I'm getting a little shabby, but I think it's been 12 years. My mom has attended 11 of 12 Aspen Valley graduations, traveling all the way from Wisconsin. Mom, I love you. Thanks for being here. And now, the wonderful staff of Aspen Valley High School. Please hold your applause until the entire staff has been introduced. Mr. Ryan Bailey, Science, Stucco, and PE. Mrs. Lisa Bejarano, Mathematics and Programming. Mrs. Kylie Caraveo, Language Arts, National Honor Society. Mrs. Heather Chavez, Science, Health. Mrs. Kelly Daniel, Foreign Language and Business. Mrs. Kathy Dearden, School Social Worker. Mrs. Kathy Emice-Beers, School Psychologist. Mr. Eugene Fisher, Social Studies. Mrs. Joe Fletcher, my right-hand woman and administrative assistant. Mr. Doug Fritz, Building Manager. Mrs. Suzanne Geislinger, School and Counselor Secretary. Mr. Peter Hamlin, Language Arts, Social Studies, Dean of Students. Mr. Craig Lown, Mathematics. Mrs. Lil Mailers, Counselor. Mrs. Chris Mang, Language Arts, Social Studies, Senior Wrangler. It's a lot harder than it looks. Mrs. Susie Padilla, Bookkeeper. Mrs. Tamaria Padilla, Librarian. Mr. Jeff Pittman, Technology Technician. Mrs. Cassandra Reese, School Nurse. Mr. Gary Savorn, Counselor. Mrs. Jenny Stevenson, Language Arts, Drama, Literacy, and Freshman Wrangler. Mrs. Karen Wasserman, Special Education, MTSS, Tag, Art Photography, Yearbook, and about 20 other things. We also want to welcome our friends from Academy Online High School, Mr. Nathan Gorsch, Principal. Mrs. Donna Tottenhagen, Principal Secretary. Mrs. Jessica Garrett, Counselor. Mrs. Rhonda Spradling, Curriculum Development Coordinator. Martha Hinson, SAFE Counselor. Angela Cross, English Language Arts. Frank Kimelek, Mathematics. Patty Kreidel, Social Studies. And Cheryl Sullivan, Office Assistant. Thank you for all that you do for our kids. And finally, let's recognize the people without whom we would not be here today to celebrate you, our seniors. Would the parents, guardians, family members, and significant others of our students please stand and be recognized? Seniors, that's an awful lot of people here just for you. That should tell you something about how much you matter. Now, it's my pleasure to introduce Dr. Mark Hatchell, Superintendent of Academy School District 20. Dr. Hatchell began his career as an educator 29 years ago as a student teacher at Air Academy High School. He graduated from Colorado State University in 1982, where he earned his bachelor's degree in business administration. He earned his master's degree from CSU in 1985. Dr. Hatchell did his doctoral studies at the University of Colorado and earned his doctoral degree in 1989. I've been in this district for a long time. We've had a lot of superintendents. Dr. Hatchell has steadfastly stood by the role of alternative ed in this district, and I'm proud to introduce him. Dr. Hatchell.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Let me first say on behalf of my bosses, the Academy 20 Board of Education, congratulations to the class of 2016. Today is a special event, a passage in a person's life. You've been trailblazers, and you've not taken the traditional route. You've gone your own way, and you've reached the end of your Academy School District 20 time. We are proud of each and every one of you and wish you the very best in the future. I remember my favorite Aspen Valley story, and it's from about 10 years ago. And I came to the school, and Mr. Stone took me to one of the classes, and he introduced me to the class, and he says, this is the guy that's in charge of the district. As we were leaving, I overheard one of the students say, "Dude looks too young to be in charge of anything to me." I don't hear that anymore when I come to Aspen Valley. I'm disappointed by that. But I've had many opportunities this year to go to Aspen Valley, and I can't tell you how impressed I've been, not only with your school, but this senior class in particular. Great job. Class of 2016, you've accomplished a lot. But before you go, I want to ask three things of you. Number one, thank your family. Number two, when you get a chance, thank your teachers. And number three, please, during this end of year graduation season, make safe and wise decisions. It is now my honor to introduce the Academy School District 20 Board of Education President, Mr. Glenn Street. Vice President, Ms. Tracy Johnson. Treasurer, Mr. Larry Borland. Director, Ms. Linda Van Mater. Director, Ms. Catherine Bullock. Air Force Academy Liaison, Colonel Troy Harding. Deputy Superintendent, Ms. Karen Reynolds. It is now my pleasure to once again introduce Ms. Catherine Bullock. Ms. Bullock is the Aspen Valley Liaison and a big supporter of Academy Online High School. Ms. Bullock grew up in Las Vegas as the eighth of 11 children. She worked for a public accounting firm for 7 years before leaving to take on even more difficult duties as CEO of her home. She currently has a part-time accounting business. Ms. Bullock graduated from Brigham Young University in accounting. Ms. Bullock is involved, very involved in her church. In her spare time, she loves to read, sew, travel, water ski, snow ski, and spend time with her family. She has five children, Corinne, Danielle, Allison, Cassandra, and Justin, who all attend or who have graduated from District 20 schools. Ms. Bullock.
A friend of mine is an avid mountain biker. Recently, he was on a fast ride on his brand new bike when his handlebars, which are a little bit wider than what he was used to, caught a tree branch. This knocked him off balance and resulted in a chain reaction that ended up with him tumbling down a hill and landing in a ditch. As he lay at the bottom of the ditch, bruised and scraped up with his brand new bike on top of him, his son, who was riding just behind him, came upon the scene, stopped, observed the situation, pulled out his phone, and took a picture. As I reflect on this story, I realize there are many valuable life lessons to be learned from bicycle riding. Lesson number one, keep moving forward. When our kids were little, my husband would take them to a huge parking lot and teach them to ride a bike. As they sat stationary on the bike, they were stable because Dad was holding on. But as soon as they would begin to move, the handlebars would start to wobble back and forth, the bike would rock, and they would say, "Slow down, slow down." Because what they didn't realize is that you have to get to a certain speed to gain momentum and stability. Author Maxwell Maltz, in using the same analogy, says, we maintain our balance, poise, and sense of security only as we are moving forward. We are built to conquer environments, solve problems, achieve goals, and we find no real satisfaction or happiness in life without obstacles to conquer and goals to achieve. Keep moving forward. You have accomplished your goal of graduating from high school. That should be the beginning step as you climb through education and life, and not the pinnacle of your achievement, Set new goals to work towards. Lesson number 2, don't be afraid to fall down. In the process of learning to ride a bike, sometimes we fall, sometimes we get hurt, and even get our picture taken. Sometimes it's painful to scrape the rocks and dirt out of our wounds. Mistakes and setbacks are an inevitable part of living. But every time we fall, we need to get back up. As Maltz further says, you make mistakes, mistakes don't make you. Lesson number 3, keep your focus on your goals. Once while on a family bike ride, my daughter looked behind her to see where we were. As she turned her head, so did her handlebars. And soon she found herself wrapped around a guardrail at the side of the road, arms and legs flailing everywhere. Always keep your eye on your goal. You look, you move in the direction you are looking. Jack Canfield said, successful people stay focused on past successes rather than their past failures, and on the next steps they need to take to get them closer to the fulfillment of their goals, rather than all the other distractions that life presents to them. Lesson number 4, stay close to your family and friends who love you. On a family bike ride in Vancouver years ago, we were riding down a trail going down a long hill. My youngest daughter got so over-anxious that she flew past us at light speed. We yelled after her, slow down, stay close. Just a few seconds later, we saw a mushroom cloud of dust rising from where she had crashed. Always listen to the advice of your family who loves you. Stay close to them. Lesson number 5, go forward with confidence. While learning to ride, my kids would always insist that we keep holding on to the back of the bike and never let go. Often they would turn around and make sure we were still hanging on. Graduates, your family, friends, and teachers have prepared you well to be successful in life. Go forward with confidence. As Jeffrey Holland says, the past is to be learned from, but not lived in. We look back to claim the embers from glowing experiences, but not the ashes. And when we have learned what we need to learn and brought with us the best that we have experienced, then we look ahead and remember that faith is always pointed toward the future. Graduates, keep moving forward. Don't be afraid of failure. Keep your eye on your goal. Stay close to your family. Go forward with confidence and always have your camera ready. Best wishes in your future and God bless you.
Seniors, one of your teachers, Mr. Hamlin, knows a little bit about crashing bikes. You might want to ask him about that. At each graduation, members of our senior class are asked if any of them wish to speak. Several students wanted to share their thoughts with you this morning. First, I would like to introduce Ms. Lauren Ashley.
Oh, this is a lot more terrifying than you imagined. Okay. Good morning, students, teachers, administrators, and families. We all know why we're here today, but since we only get to do this once, congratulations to the class of 2016. As a member of the 20th graduating class of Aspen Valley High School, it is with great honor that my classmates and I are able to receive a diploma from this remarkable institution. And from the longest extension of our hearts, thank you. Before I came to stand in front of you today, I had no idea of what content I was going to address in the last moments of my high school career. Partially due to the fact that there were so many potential insights that I could provide, and partially due to the fact that I spent so much time talking that the pressure of figuring out how to conclude it was intense, to say the very least. But somehow, I've managed to sort through 4 years of experiences and accumulated knowledge just to say that destiny is not a thing. You are not bound to a certain path, required to pursue something conventionally realistic, or even limited to what you can accomplish. And if I had a nickel for every time that I was told to do something with my life, maybe then and only then, my destiny would be to open a bank. Life is not about waiting for things to happen, it's about making those things happen. My senior quote, beauty begins the moment you decide to be yourself. spoken truthfully by Coco Chanel, emphasized my journey through high school. Though to me, being myself was more than a decision, it was and remains to be a heated debate between the person that I am and the person that I'm working to become. As a freshman, I dreamt of a woman in a beautifully tailored suit and Christian Louboutin pumps. As she strutted through town, laughing with her other fabulous coworkers on their way to lunch, I knew that she was a spinning image of who I wanted to be. On multiple occasions in the weeks preceding this ceremony, I was asked to provide a piece of advice for someone working towards graduation, and I always said, figure out who you want to be and become that person. While I literally dreamt of my future, all of these graduates sitting in front of me today can accurately be depicted as dreamers. We believe that our dreams can be converted into dedications, and we also believe that the sky does not define our limitations, because we know that the future holds more than just what's in our immediate sight. That's a lesson that we've learned during our time at Aspen Valley. Sure, we've endured the rumors and the drama, but when we're standing up here, we don't remember that. We remember laughing until we cried on multiple occasions, being recognized for something that we worked extremely hard on, and dancing the night away at prom, regardless of our 20-pound dresses. And maybe that last one is a bit more applicable to me than anyone else, but we've all made memories like that. They're the memories that make this day more about enjoying the journey and not just the destination. Today we justify our tassels to the right instead of our papers. Today we get to rejoice in the beauty that tomorrow will bring. And today we get to walk across a short stage honoring our long walk up to it. As we make our way across the platform and dive into a sea of hugs, greeting cards, and congratulations, we have also initiated an expedition of unlimited potential. The formation of a powerful memory is taking place right now for at least 22 individuals in this very room. And we all know that there are more than just 22. Whether you're making the memories or contributing to someone else's, you have the privilege of being here to share this remarkable experience. We commend you on being present for this astounding moment in our lives. And it wouldn't really be my speech unless I had a surprise, if I can find it in here.
It's right here.
I would like to invite anyone in the audience who feels as though they've been impacted by one of these graduates to stand. Class of 2016, look around you. These are your advocates for your efforts, inspirations, and endurances. You haven't just made it, you have been triumphant. Thank you. And now I'd like to invite my fellow senior, Stephanie, and my dear friend to share her thoughts with us.
Thank you, Lauren. Sorry, I'm gonna see if I can do this without crying. Nearly 10 months ago, I walked through the doors of Aspen Valley as a nervous yet excited emotional mess, kind of like I am today.
It's okay.
I had no idea what to expect or if my last chance to graduate would even work out. It's funny. I never dreamed that I would be happy and proud to say that I'm a 21-year-old high school graduate. But now that the day has come, I couldn't be more grateful. Aspen wasn't just a school to me. It was not only a place where I could come and be myself without people judging. It became my second home. This last year of school has been the most terrifying, amazing, and challenging year I've ever faced. But I think it made me a stronger person. Being here has taught me that not everything you want is easily achieved. But if you work hard enough and are surrounded by loving, caring people, everything will work out. There are so many people to thank for helping me get through this last year of high school. I'm not quite sure there's enough time to name everyone. The first person I would like to thank for her never-ending support and love is my amazing, wonderful mom. She has done... She has done so much for me, even though all the difficult times that have come upon us both over this last year. Honestly, I don't think I would be standing up here trying to read this speech without crying if it wasn't for her endless encouraging me to be the best I could be. The next person on my to thank list is Mrs. Meng, a truly selfless and amazingly caring person who has gone above and beyond to help me with everything from going to prom to looking over my college essays. Miss Meng, you are and always will be my school mom, and I will forever hold you in my heart. I love you so much. Miss B, my amazing programming teacher. You made every single class fun, no matter what we were doing. Your over-enthusiastic way of teaching math and programming helped me to love both almost as much as you do. Every teacher played a part in helping me to reach this point, and please know that I will be forever grateful to each and every one of you for the rest of my life. Out of the whopping 100 and something students at this amazing school, there are a few who I would love to embarrass by saying some overly emotional words about them. Janaea, you're lucky number one. We met on the first day of school. You were my guide and showed me around while introducing me to some of my new teachers. I want you to know that I am so very glad you're in my life. Every class with you was an adventure, and I couldn't ask for a better friend. Emma, my sweet, sweet human. Even though we only got to know each other during this last semester and only had two classes together, you became one of my closest friends. I really hope we can stay friends in the future. Barbara, I don't know where to start with you. Both you and Lord made Puma especially interesting and downright hilarious with your old married couple banters. You both provided me with more laughs and good times than you'll ever know, and I want to thank you for that. Bree, I basically just want to thank you for being you, if that makes sense. China, I couldn't leave you out of my speech. I want you to know that you're an amazing and kind person who has so much to offer. One thing you have taught me over the course of the school year is to be proud of who I am, and I will carry that with me forever. One piece of advice that I have for all the freshmen, sophomores, and juniors that are here is that no matter how hard school seems, no matter how much life seems to be against you and is beating you down, don't ever give up. Life is funny like that. It'll be kind to you one day, and then the next, it'll turn around and bite you in the butt. I'm speaking from personal experience. My last year of high school was amazing in so many ways, but it was also the most challenging year I have honestly ever gone through. There were so many days where I didn't even want to go to school. All I wanted to do was stay curled up under my covers and pretend that the world didn't exist. There were even a few days where I wanted to quit school completely and become a hermit. That mindset doesn't work. You have to get up, keep your head held high, and don't let life get to you. You have to show it that you're the boss, not the other way around. Well, now that that's over, I'm slowly running out of words to say. The coming days are going to be very sad for me because I will no longer be going to school and seeing the people who have become my second family. I do know one thing for sure, and that is the fact that I am and forever will be eternally grateful to all of my Aspen Valley family for seeing me through to the end of this incredible journey. I will forever cherish the many memories that I have and never let them go. I love you all so, so much. Peace out, everyone. Next, I would like to introduce Barbara Mowry.
Lauren was right. I am a black sheep, a mixture of high sensitivity, creativity, and sarcasm. And I didn't fit into any crowd at school until I came here. Here at Aspen Valley, where I'm not the only one who's felt left out. There are all sorts here. There are kids whose ADD is so bad that I thought I lost my pencil somewhere. There are cool kids, the kids with no voice, kids with crazy, amazing talents from swimming to music to architecture. Then the kids who were told 1,000 times, you can't do it. I was one of those kids. I had teachers tell me over and over that I wouldn't be able to go forth and succeed in high school if I didn't listen to them, if I didn't fit into the mold that they set for every single student. And now I'm here doing something that, in all honesty, I didn't think I could do. I'm making my own mold and walking my own path. I'm graduating. I am successful, and that is because of the support Aspen Valley has given to me, as well as the confidence and ability to be my own person. I am so proud to tell my family that I am graduating, and I am so proud to be up here today to tell you that I did it. Aspen Valley isn't just a school, we are family. And yes, I may still be a black sheep, but there are blue sheep and pink sheep, and hell, some of us aren't even sheep. We praise each other for our differences and feed off of our weirdness. So I want to tell all of you, you aren't a stereotype, you do have a voice, and yes, you can do it. There was a period of time when I thought that Aspen was below me. And for a while, I thought that things at the school were unfair, and I was unhappy with the way things worked. I know many of you have felt the same way. But then Stone asked me if I would be on the site planning committee with himself, staff members from Aspen Valley, Summit, and other D20 representatives. I learned a lot about the teachers, what they did, and why they did it. I talked to Stone, and he explained why he ran the school the way he does. And it was very eye-opening and humbling for me. It brought me back to the ground and pushed me back a few pegs. I realized that there was still a lot I needed to learn from Aspen, even if it wasn't from my English or math classes. At Aspen, I've learned to be a leader, a listener, a friend, and most importantly, I've learned how to be me. Seniors, as you're sitting here bouncing your knees and biting your nails, so anxious and excited to walk up on the stage and turn that tassel, you need to know that you did it. This is a huge milestone we're about to pass, and it's because we put in the work. We took the time, and we've earned it. And I am proud of every single one of us. Trust me, I'm bouncing my knees in anticipation too, also nerves. We've gone through at least 12 years of public school, and this is it. To those in the audience from Aspen who still have time before their big day, if nobody else says it to you, I will. You can conquer this, you can succeed, and you can get your work done, and I know you will. Quickly, for the parents, thank you for staying sane with us and loving us through our shenanigans and awkward stages of pubescent terror. I would like to thank the teachers for being mentors and friends to all the students here, for being not only a teacher, but also a support system, an advice giver, and sometimes just somebody to joke with. To all the parents and guardians who raised my wonderful peers, thank you for bringing these amazing people into the world. This quote from Henry David Thoreau's Walden seems fitting for this occasion. I learned this, at least by my experiment, that if one advances confidently in the direction of his dreams and endeavors to live the life which he has imagined, he will meet with the success unexpected in common hours. I have succeeded, and so have all of you in front of me. Because we move forward confidently towards our dreams, and I encourage us to continue doing that through work, college, relationships, and whatever else life has in store for us. As you go home and celebrate, opening up those cards, pretending to read that sweet note from grandma, but only really paying attention to that crisp 20, keep in mind all the people who helped you make it to this day. Take some time to thank every one of the teachers who took time out of their days to help you, the staff for still believing in you, even when you started to doubt, and even after you failed, telling you you can pick yourself back up. Thank your parents, your friends, and anyone who has helped you. Finally, take a minute to appreciate what you've done here today. Once you've done all that, proceed to take all the money out of your cards and smile knowing you'll have cash for the next 2 weeks. I am a black sheep, a mixture of high sensitivity, creativity, and sarcasm, and I'm about to graduate. Thank you. And what would graduation be if the principal did not give a speech, Mr. Stone?
I still feel like I need to sing something. And I got really weird ears, so this doesn't fit just right. Can you hear me all right? For over a decade now, I've stood before graduating classes at Aspen Valley and talked about how proud we all are of you. I've then gone on to talk about each student individually, sharing the lessons that each has taught us during their time at Aspen Valley. It's odd how traditions come to be, but this has become an Aspen Valley tradition, the sharing of you. You see, each of you will be receiving your diploma today for meeting the district's graduation requirements. These requirements are primarily academic, and you're to be commended for achieving them. But your journey has been about so much more than just academics, and you have all become so much more than just skilled students. As you have learned and grown, so too have all of us who have been on this journey with you. Each of you, in your own way, has contributed to the creation of this wonderful community we call Aspen Valley. More than any principal, more than any teacher, it has been you who have built this very special place. This year, I found myself thinking about the Velveteen Rabbit and the journey to becoming real. I thought about those moments when you were at your best and were clearly becoming real. I want to remind each of you of those moments and thank you for sharing them with us. Kayla, something happened about 6 months into your time at Aspen. I have my theories about what it might have been, but whatever it was, the result was dramatic. Your walk took on a new self-assured confidence. You started showing up for school a couple days a week, dressed like you were ready for a major job interview. You guys know what I'm talking about, right? Yeah. Your eyes took on a certain sparkle. There was no longer even a hint of the darkness that had been a constant shadow when you first arrived. You remind us that once a fire is kindled, there really is no limit to how brightly it can burn. Lauren, your muse, Coco Chanel, observed that elegance is not the prerogative of those who have just escaped from adolescence, but of those who have already taken possession of their future. We've always noticed how well-dressed you are, how well-put-together you are all the time, your poise, your maturity. But I think one thing that we haven't appreciated is how intentional it is. As I started writing these comments about you, I found myself remembering my father. When I was your age, my dad always tried to instill in me that the way we compose ourselves, the way we dress, the way we polish our shoes, the way we clean under our fingernails, those are often the keys that open the doors. They're the first impressions that we make on others. And that first impression often opens the door that allows us to show others our intelligence and our competence. I want to thank you for preserving this ancient bit of wisdom that my father shared with me and carrying it forward into your generation. Michaela, last woman standing. How many times has that been our code to take the next impossible step towards this day? Like the Velveteen Rabbit, we can get pretty beat up along the way. The journey to real sometimes requires us to pick ourselves up over and over again. I don't know who this quote is from, but it makes me think of you. She was a true fighter. You could see it in her eyes. She was not born strong, she was made strong. She was sculpted to be her own hero when the world let her down, and she kept picking herself back up. Michaela, I want you to remember those words. Today you get your diploma, and you've walked through fire to earn it. But the most important thing to remember about this day is that you found the strength to get here. Know that the same strength is now available to you every day for the rest of your life. Ryan. Okay, I guess that's it. All right. Stephanie. Ryan, author Sam Keen said, there are two questions a man must ask himself. The first is, where am I going? The second is, who's going to go with me? If you ever get these questions in the wrong order, you're setting yourself up for trouble. I remember a time when you asked the second question first and the first question second. It's a hard thing because I know how deeply you value your friends. I know how committed you are to your friends. And loving and being loved is a critical piece to becoming real. This year, you finally got the questions in the right order. Where am I going? First. Who's going with me? Second. But in the process, you reminded us that we can still love those around us tightly, even though we realize they may only be in our lives for a short time. Stephanie. Have you ever wondered why everyone around here likes you so much? Okay. You fit in so well with so many different people. It's because what you see in those around you is a reflection of you. Musician Ed Sheeran said, the main thing is that you have to remember on this journey is just be nice to everyone and smile. Your graciousness, your kindness, and your warmth are infectious. The Velveteen Rabbit became real because he loved authentically, even in the face of hardship. You remind us that love is a critical component of realizing our better selves, and that the love we give is returned to us in equal measure. So, Shelby, I'm a huge Game of Thrones fan, all right? Not because of the violence or the questionable morals, all right? But because I'm inspired by some of the characters who face one challenge after another and just keep getting up. One of my favorite characters is played by Natalie Dormer. During an interview, she captured your journey and its lesson for us in the following quote. She said, "For me, it's not necessarily interesting to play a strong, fearless woman. It's interesting to play a woman who is terrified and then overcomes that fear. It's about the journey. Courage is not the absence of fear. It is the overcoming of it. By that measure, I believe you are one of the most courageous women I've ever met." Janaea. This? Yeah. You're welcome, daughter. Someone once said that a true friend is someone who brings out the best in you. Janae, I think about all the ways you make people better around Aspen Valley. I think about you in your silly moods, when you're just full of unrestrained energy, and how that, like, scatters to everyone around you and makes everyone feel energetic and happy. I think about you in your creative moods, when you came up with the idea of the matching tattoos for you and Kim. And I remember the goofy looks you both had on your faces when you finally came and showed them. I think about you in your giving moods. I think about the time when you independently came up with the idea of a clothing drive for the needy, and then you made it happen. In your best moments, you just shine with positive energy. And in those moments, you make all of us better. Okay. Yeah, so I read this like 20 times to try to desensitize myself so I wouldn't cry. Brie, Japanese poet Haruki Murakami wrote about transformation. He said, "And once the storm is over, you won't remember how you made it through, how you managed to survive. You won't even be sure whether the storm is really over. But one thing is certain. When you come out of the storm, you won't be the same person who walked in. That's what the storm is all about. We've known each other since you were in seventh grade. You came to me as a storm. Then you left, and the storm went with you. And then you asked if you could return, and I wasn't sure I wanted to let the storm back in. And then you asked again. and again, and again, and we resumed our journey. I knew that I wanted to write that about you. I didn't know what else I wanted to write about you until about 2 weeks ago when we were in my office, and we didn't use the word storm, but we talked about the storm and how it had changed you. I wish you could have seen your own face. It's a face I've known for 6 years. And the clarity of your gaze, the light of your spirit, the storm has passed. You're ready. Barbara, Beverly Engel writes about women's issues. She says, "The messages you receive from society may have caused you to believe that assertiveness is unacceptable or even dangerous. Practice saying the following: I have the right to be treated with respect by others. I have the right to express my feelings and opinions. I have the right to say no without feeling guilty. I have the right to ask for what I want. I have the right to make my own mistakes. I have the right to happiness." I think about all the times that you've come to my office to talk about school climate, issues related to leadership or policy, or just to check in on or advocate for a fellow student. More than any other graduate here today, you've been willing to engage in discussions that have helped shape me as a leader and our school as a community. I thank you for that, and I'm going to miss that voice. Okay, Sky. I have a toast for you, Sky. Yeah. Here's to the girls who don't wake up with perfect hair, who don't wear 50 pounds of makeup, and who'd rather spend the day in jeans than in a dress. It might not seem that important, but when I remember you, I will also feel this slight pull to go for a hike or drive a random dirt road or just go get muddy, all right? In this world where we spend our time behind computers killing virtual things or watching Netflix compulsively, you remind us all to just get out and play the old-fashioned way. I'll leave you with an old country blessing. May your trucks be lifted, your men strong, your boots muddy, your nights starry, your days sunny, and your life country. Katie, it seems like I haven't seen you in forever. You completed your graduation requirements at the end of the first semester, and boom, you're gone, all right? Your absence holds a lesson for all of your classmates, though. You see, this moment is about triumph and celebration. But really, it's just another moment in your journey. You wrapped things up and walked out the door, confidently looking forward to the next chapter of your life. Teddy Roosevelt described you best when he said, "It's far better to dare mighty things, to win glorious triumphs, even though checkered by failure, than to take rank with those poor spirits who neither enjoy much nor suffer much because they live in the gray twilight that knows neither victory nor defeat. One of the things I cherish about you is your confidence and the way that you just walk on to the next part of your life." Bree. Such a serious woman. What's always struck me about you is your focus and your intensity. Most of the people in the audience don't know that I've pretty much known every nicest woman that was ever born while I was alive. And each of you has been very different. You're the old soul. Estee Lauder said that you don't get there by wishing for it or hoping for it, but by working for it. One of the most impressive things about you and your lesson for our younger students is that you have always been willing to do the work necessary to succeed. You get impatient and frustrated, and every now and then you break just a little bit, but you never fail to get back up and resume your journey. You're going to go far because you don't spend a whole lot of time feeling sorry for yourself. You have more important things to do. That's our Bree. Ashley, to the outside observer, you might appear to be a pretty dark person. Your taste in music, your personal style tending toward the darker tones. Make sure you check out her mortarboard before you leave. Your love of Tim Burton movies. But for those of us who have watched you these past few years, there's actually a great deal of light. No queen of darkness dresses up in her Pikachu onesie. No dark soul finds an enduring relationship like yours with Wyatt. No terminally negative person rocks a gothic Victorian dress like you did at prom. You see, every real person is made up of both darkness and light. And the truth is that light can only really be understood with the wisdom of darkness. The one thing that stands out about you, Josh, when I think about you, is the intensity of your friendships here at Aspen Valley. I close my eyes and I can remember you. I can see you sitting in the hallway. Sometimes you were the one hurting, and it was Gabby or Sarah or Evan or someone was there with you, helping you through the moment. Sometimes it was Gabby or somebody else that was hurting, and you were the one sitting there helping them through the moment, lifting them up. Your empathy for others helps them and you become real. At the beginning of this, I talked about one of the things about Aspen Valley is we love each other into becoming real. You're not only the best looking boy in the senior class, you're the poster child for empathy. Shakespeare knew what you also know. A friend is one that knows you as you are, understands where you have been, accepts what you have become, and still gently allows you to grow. Dylan, what are little boys made of? No, what are little boys made of? Snips and snails and puppy dog tails? Yeah. At least that's what ring dolls are made of, right? All right. I don't know what it is about you and your entire family. You guys are just fun and full of energy. Dylan, you move through the world with this carefree lightness, like some inner part of you knows that whatever life brings, you'll handle it. In education, we have a technical term for that, for this quality that you possess. It's called resilience. It's the ability to adapt well in the face of adversity. It's the ability to find your smile, find your laughter, even after you've lost it. I'm not sure where it comes from in you. I suspect your father. But it's a rare and precious quality. Eli, my memory of you is sort of a composite of a few interactions that we've had over the years. The most recent addition occurred the day this semester when you and your brother were involved in that parking lot altercation with a Bridges customer. We never did sort out exactly what happened, and you were upset about being accused of something that you were adamant you hadn't done. The thing I remember, though, is the way you handled yourself. You were the absolute role model for how we should stand up for ourselves when faced with adversity. And I want to share the characteristics you displayed as my final advice to this class. You were angry, but you never lost your cool. You asked specific, appropriate, but pointed questions. You followed up, coming to see me again to pursue resolution. You were patient and allowed the process to work itself out. You've already learned one of the secrets to success in life. It's also the secret to becoming real without getting too beat up in the process. Graduating class of Aspen Valley, you're probably one of the most special classes I have ever had the pleasure of working with. I'm going to miss you guys more than you know. Thank you.
It is now my pleasure to introduce Mr. Nathan Gorsch, Principal of Academy Online High School, the second Principal of Academy Online High School. Mr. Gorsch is in his second year as the principal after serving as an assistant principal for 11 years, with the last 4 years being at Pine Creek High School. He graduated from Lincoln Christian College with a bachelor's degree in Christian education and Illinois State University, where he earned his bachelor's degree in history. He earned his master's degree in curriculum instruction from Colorado Christian University. Mr. Gorsch now leads one of the best online schools in the state. The school has grown to where it now serves 368 students with 25 staff members. And we have 8 graduating seniors, and 6 of them are here today. Graduates, congratulations. Mr. Gorsch is not resting on his laurels. He is also an innovative leader, and he has an eye towards the future of education. This year, Academy Online piloted an excited blended program for 9th grade students under his leadership, and we expect even more exciting things in the future. Mr. Gorsch.
Once again, congratulations, class of 2016. This is a special day for you and your family to look back at all you've accomplished, and also an exciting time to look to the future. But as we take the opportunity to look both back and forward, I'd like to share a poem by William Stafford called The Way It Is. There's a thread you follow. It goes among the things that change, but it doesn't change. People wonder about what you're pursuing. You have to explain about the thread, for it is hard for others to see. While you hold it, you can't get lost. Tragedies happen, people get old or die, and you suffer and you get old. But nothing you can do can stop time's unfolding, but you don't ever let go of the thread. As we celebrate here today, I'm wondering, what is your thread? What is that one word, idea, or emotion that you just can't seem to let go of? For some of you, it may be equity. For others, justice. For some, love. For some, it may have spiritual significance. For others, it may be about your family. And for some, it may be an academic pursuit. For some, it's to make the world a better place than you found it. For others, to right a wrong. And for others, it may be to bring joy to others. You may not know it yet, but this thread will shape you. This thread will keep you awake at night. It might be the only reason you get out of bed on some mornings. Even when you're not thinking about it, it boils just below the surface. The thread is so strong that some people build their entire lives around trying to ignore it. My hope for you today is that you already know this thread in your life. If you've not yet discovered it, my hope is you discover it soon. For this thread brings meaning, it brings purpose, and it brings richness to your life. For a few moments, let's talk about how powerful this thread can be. Number one, this thread likely played a role in you choosing Academy Online High School or Aspen Valley High School. You see, for each person here, you have a story. None of you came to Academy Online or to Aspen Valley because it was your neighborhood school. You each chose your school because of an opportunity, because of a challenge, or because of something else that is likely connected to your thread. Some of you wanted to have an environment that just gave you the time, the space, or the emotional energy to deal with your thread. Number two, this thread pushes you towards risk. I recently had a conversation with an educational consultant that works for Apple. Apple does something unique in that it allows its employees to kind of give themselves a job title. And his job title is Educational Instigator. As a side note, I'd like to maybe have a conversation about my job title with Dr. Hatchell and the Board of Education. He said the mantra at Apple is fail early, fail small, and fail forward. Their culture is built to encourage failure, and the mistakes are seen as opportunities. Allow your thread to push you into places that you're not comfortable and that you're not going to experience early success. Because anything worth having or achieving has an element of risk. Number three, this thread will shape your dreams. When you close your eyes and you imagine doing what you love, what do you picture? It's likely connected to your thread. It's what takes your breath away. It's what angers you. It's what brings you tears, and it's what you do when you're at your best. And finally, this thread can and will define you. Whether you tend to it or not, this thread will consume you. The same Apple employee was talking about the development of the iPhone 6. When they developed the iPhone 6, they had 43 different teams just working on the camera portion of the phone. It became an obsession to get it right. and so they gave time and resources to get it right. Your thread takes up a great deal of your emotional energy and your mental resources, but that's because you have to get it right. Mark Twain may have said it best when he said, "The two most important days in your life are the day you're born and the day you find out why." Simon Sinek, who's one of my favorite authors, says it this way: working hard for something that we don't care about is called stress. Working hard for something we love is called passion. Class of 2016, each of you has a thread you cling to tightly, something you can't let go of. Use this thread to do the incredible. Use it to find cures for diseases. Use it to love the marginalized, and use it to make this world a better place for your classmates and for future generations. If you remember the Apple commercial from a couple years ago, here's how they described it. Here's to the crazy ones, the misfits, the rebels, the troublemakers, the round pegs in the square holes, the ones who see things differently. They're not fond of rules and they have no respect for the status quo. You can quote them, you can disagree with them, you can glorify them or you can vilify them, but the one thing you can't do is ignore them, because they change things. They push the human race forward, and while some may see them as the crazy ones, we see genius, because the people who are crazy enough to think that they can change the world are usually the ones who do. Congratulations, class of 2016. Go change the world.
Thank you, Nathan. Now we have a little surprise. I would like to welcome Mr. Glenn Strieb, CEO of Air Academy Federal Credit Union and president of our Board of Education. He is representing the District Academy District 20 Education Foundation. Each year, the Academy District 20 Education Foundation has been a steadfast supporter of all of our students. And each year, they have a little something special. So without further ado, Mr. Strieb.
As a member of the Board of Academy School District 20 Education Foundation, I'm proud to be here and happy to be here to provide a $1,000 scholarship to an unsuspecting student today. The foundation is an all-volunteer board that works sometimes tirelessly, sometimes not so tirelessly. We work a lot to raise funds, primarily through a golf tournament, and we also raise funds by people just making donations to us, whether it's at the end of the year because they're trying to change their tax situation a little bit, or because some of the things that we do, that's why they contribute. Some of the things that we do, over the past 3 years, the foundation earmarked $50,000 to help with Academy District 20 professional development for teachers, of course, as well as providing some things for parents. We provide a number of grants to classrooms, and these are programs that are not funded by the district, but are all based around education. In the past year, we have contributed, and we will do this again going forward. Past year, we've contributed to the China Exchange Program, and we also have contributed to the High Trails Program, and each year we provide scholarships. This year, for the first time, we provided a $10,000 scholarship in a district-wide, if you want to call it a competition or a scholarship program, as well as a $5,000 scholarship. And those have already been handed out. In addition, we give a $1,000 scholarship to each of the schools and an Academy Online as well as Aspen Valley are combined into one. So every year we give thousands and thousands of dollars to support this outstanding school district, and we're very happy to do that. The program is selected by the principal, and the criteria is they must have demonstrated outstanding leadership, and I think based on some of the things that you have heard this morning, there's truly outstanding leadership here in the class. Student must be in the top one-third academically of the graduating class. The student must have participated significantly in community service. Student must have demonstrated exemplary qualities of character and integrity, and the scholarship must be used for post-secondary education. This year's winner, again, this is unbeknownst to them, there's a couple of bullets that have been prepared, and I'll try to stumble through them to make sure that I don't give it away too early. They're currently working while also attending college, wants to study business and marketing, will attend UCCS, where she, that gives away part of it, has received the Chancellor's Award. Has been a leader in student council, all year. Everyone's already starting to point to each other and see out who it is. I'm getting indications from the front row that it's somebody in the front row. But I've been a leader in student council all year, has mentored new ninth graders at Aspen Valley High School. Now I'm getting closer and warmer. Had to interview, and you heard it in the comments earlier, had to interview multiple times before being accepted in Aspen Valley. Has been a D20 lifer, which means that she's gone to D20 her entire time. And this will, maybe this won't give it away, but loves to get salty and nag Mr. Stone. But this will definitely give it away. She brought her dog to prom this year. Ladies and gentlemen, our $1,000 scholarship winner, Bree Hattersley, please come forward.
So we're not quite done with the surprises. You guys aren't the only ones graduating today. Karen, can you join me for a minute? I might actually cry on this one. You know, you heard me talk a little while ago about how Barbara helped, and you guys have all helped shape me as a leader. You know, I started on my journey to become a principal. I was pretty rough around the edges. And the journey to becoming real, the Velveteen Rabbit story, it wasn't just about you. All right? It was also about me. Along that journey, you have stood steadfastly by me. You've asked me the hard questions. You've pointed me in the right direction. And you've never left my side. And I thank you for that. And what you guys need to know out there is that she has not just done that for me. Karen has done that for this entire district. She has been one of the strongest advocates for alternative education in District 20. I've been here 12 years, which is a long time. Karen has been one of the strongest advocates for alternative ed in my tenure at District 20. Before that, she was an advocate for alternative ed at East Middle School, at Palmer High School. You spent a career doing this. So we got you some swag. We'd like to present this to you on behalf of Academy Online High School and Aspen Valley High School and all the thousands of kids that you've helped in your career.
Thank you. Thank you.
And she had no idea that was coming. At the end, Karen, I have the nice decorative box, so you can protect that. Wow, so now we're getting to the part that where the rubber meets the road. Nathan?
Yes.
We tried to do this, like, you know, would you read this?
Yeah, I will.
Now, Mrs. Bullock, it is with the greatest of pride that we present to you the members of the class of 2016. I hereby certify that these, and Mr. Stone also certifies, that these young men and women have met the requirements for graduation from Aspen Valley High School, Academy Online High School, and Academy School District 20, and they are recommended for their diplomas.
On behalf of the Board of Education of Academy School District 20, I accept with pride and pleasure the 2016 graduating class of Aspen Valley High School and Academy Online High School. Mr. Stone, Mr. Gorsh, thank you, your faculty and staff, for an outstanding job.
Yeah. Staff members, please prepare to greet our seniors as they receive their diplomas. Mr. Hamlin, I need you. Mr. Hamlin, are you here? Oh, well, hello.
Thank you, sir.
You're welcome.
Hi,
have the extreme honor of getting to read the thank yous that students have written to those they want to thank. And I would like to start with Kayla Renee Alverson. Kayla says, thank you to all the people who supported me through this process. I appreciate all of the opportunities that I've been presented with and feel well prepared for the future. Lauren Francis Ashley. And Lauren says, I would like to thank my family and friends for always being around when I needed them, and to the staff at Aspen Valley for valuing real-life applications of the subjects addressed in the classroom. In particular, I thank Mr. Pittman for allowing me to vent for a good semester or two. Michaela Jean Bass. Michaela says, I would like to thank my mom first for always supporting me and staying by my side and for never giving up on me or doubting me through all the good and all the bad I've done. I'd also like to thank my sister Rebecca and her boyfriend Nate for supporting me and pushing me to get everything done, especially those late nights with college papers the night before they were due. I'd also like to thank the staff, especially Mr. Bailey, for always listening. And I'd like to thank Mr. Stone. Even though we've had our ups and downs, you've been there for me since eighth grade. You never let me think dropping out was an option. Ryan Michael Berg. Ryan says, I would like to thank everyone at Aspen Valley for pushing me to be the best I could be. I would also like to thank my amazing family for their support throughout the years. I would also like to thank my best friends, Summer and Sean, and my amazing girlfriend, Brianna, for always having my back. Thank you, everyone, for their support. I will miss you all. Stephanie Michelle Eisenstadt. Stephanie says, this year has been the most exciting, interesting, and challenging year ever as far as school goes. I want to say a huge thank you to all of my teachers, whom I've had the absolute honor of getting to know. Thank you to my amazing fellow seniors for welcoming me to Aspen Valley and making me feel at home every single day. I love you all, and I'm going to miss everyone deeply. Shelby Lane Farnsworth. Shelby says, I would like to thank Mrs. Wasserman for always helping me out and giving me someone to talk to. I really appreciate all the help. I would also like to thank Mr. Pittman. He was always there for me and given me someone to talk to when I was going through tough times. I would also like to thank my dad for always being there and helping me through. I know it was not easy. Finally, I would like to thank my mom for being my best friend and for being there for me. Janaea Marie Harris. Janaea says, I want to thank my mom and dad, my Aunt Laurie and Uncle Dave, and my best friend Kim for helping me stay on track to graduation, even when I had given up. Thanks especially to my mom and Kim because you are both there for me every day. I also want to thank Mrs. Bejarano, Ms. Mailers, Mr. Savorin, Mr. Stone, and Mama Jo for dealing with my attitude all year. Brianna Nicole Hattersley. Bree says, I would like to thank my family and friends for being a phenomenal support system and for encouraging me to do my best, especially my mother for being the biggest driving force in my life, my best friend, and my motivation to achieve goals. I would also like to thank my best friends, Barbara and Lauren, for making my senior year the most memorable. Jupiter, my cat, has always been my homie since I could talk, and he's been the best listener I have ever encountered. Thank you, Jupiter. And lastly, Mr. Stone, for giving me a chance at success and for believing in me, even when I was on the verge of giving up on myself. Barbara Ann Mowry. Yeah! Barbara says, after the 4 years of high school, my biggest supporters are the ones I want to thank the most. My mother and father have been there with me every step of the way, and I am blessed to have them, so accepting of all my choices. My friends have also been a huge help, so I'd like to thank Lauren Ashley and Bree Hattersley. My brother David has been one of my best friends and has always lifted me up when I needed him to. My baby sister, Alexi, has also taught me to enjoy the little things. There have been also many teachers that have helped me along the way stay on the right path. Thank you, Mr. Bailey, Mrs. Mang, Mr. Fisher, and Mrs. Bejarano. Last but not least, thank you, Mr. Stone. Skyly Dean Thelen Moy. Skyly says, thank you, Aspen Valley, for giving me a second chance, for showing me that there are still good people left in the world. Big thanks to Alicia, Ryan, and Michaela for being my darn good friends and keeping me out of jail. Thanks to my amazing family for not giving up on me, and most importantly, thanks to my truck, Ranger, for getting me out of the mud every time. Caitlin Marie Nance. Katie says, I would like to thank my family and teachers for always believing in me. I would like to personally thank Mr. Stone for giving me the extra push I needed to get back on track for graduation when I was struggling to get through. Brianna Hope Niseth. And Brianna says, I want to thank my parents for their continuous love and support, especially my mom for always being there for me when I wanted to give up. You pushed me to the finish line. I want to thank my sister, Summer, for always being my shoulder to cry on. You are my best friend. Thank you to all my friends and family and my teachers for never leaving my side and staying with me through the continuous struggle. Thank you all. Ashley Marie Payne. And Ashley says, thank you, Mom and Dad, for helping me get through high school when I thought I wasn't going to. I wouldn't have been able to get through without your support. I would also like to thank all the teachers for helping me get through these years. Thanks to all my friends for being there when I thought I wasn't going to make it. I'm here. Joshua Caleb Polis. Josh says, this year has been by far one of the toughest years of my life, but of course a couple people have helped me survive it all. I specifically want to thank my parents for all their support. I also want to thank my best friends Emily Davis, Madeline Lewis, and Shelby Farnsworth for always being there to support me. Dylan Nathaniel Ringdahl. Dylan says, I would like to thank my family for pushing me to try my best. I would especially like to thank my brother Dustin and my dad for recommending that I go to Aspen Valley. Thank you, Mr. Hamblin. You made a big difference and kept me on track. In addition, I would like to thank the entire Aspen Valley staff for believing in me. Also, Nate Thomas, you gave me a lot of confidence and were always there when I needed you. I am grateful. And finally, I would like to thank myself for being an absolute boss. Eli Francis Eligio Tercero III. And Eli would like to say, I would like to thank my mother and father for supporting me through my education. Thank you to my wonderful girlfriend, Esther. You're perfect in every way and have made my high school year unforgettable. Thank you, Alicia, Rowan, Brandon, and all my other friends at Aspen Valley for giving me endless laughter and joyful moments. Finally, thank you to all my teachers here at Aspen Valley. My dreams would not be possible without you.
Andrew Barron. Andrew says, first off, I would like to thank all my teachers, especially Mrs. Cook, Mrs. Straub, Mr. McGillihenny, Dr. Ricotta, Coach Wadsworth, and Dr. Hamm, who encouraged me to finish what I started. I would also like to thank my family for always being there for moral support, most importantly, my mom. I've had my ups and downs through my journey of high school and would never have finished if it weren't for you all. I greatly appreciate everything that each and every one of you have done. Thank you, everybody, for being here and believing in me.
Olivia Marie Martin. I want to thank my mom and dad for all their encouragement, my old teachers at Aspen Valley, and especially all the staff at the Partnership Academy. Without all of you guys, I don't think I'd be walking across this stage today. Sometimes you just meet all the right people at all the right times.
Raina Mickelson. At this time, I wish to give thanks to the following people. Martha Henson, who was always available to help me with my classes when I needed. Michael Arsenault for always being positive and encouraging me to do better. Diane Forsyth, who was a huge part in helping me graduate early, as well as my family, who was always there for me when I needed them.
Brianna Lynn Roberts. I would like to thank all of the people who have helped giving me the chance to be here. From teachers, friends, family, including mom and stepdad, who have put a great effort into making sure work was done and giving me motivation. I appreciate the time and the hard work they put into making sure I made it. Also, my friend Sigourney, who helped me tremendously with math. I give thanks to everyone who gave me the chance to make it this far.
Adriana Deanne Shear. I want to thank my parents for supporting me and encouraging me to be my best. I want to say thank you to Mrs. Spradling and Mrs. Loomis for teaching me how to improve as a student. I want to thank my counselors, Mrs. Henson and Mrs. Garrett, for helping me prepare for my future. Most importantly, I want to thank God for giving me the strength and patience to stay focused on my goals, even in the midst of struggles.
Ariana Marie Werther. I want to say thank you to everybody who helped me come this far. Thank you, God, for everything you've done for and have given me. Thank you to my family for showing me love and supporting me as well. Thank you to my parents for everything you've done for me. Thank you to my teachers. Doing school online was a great decision I've made, which wouldn't have happened without the help of my mom. Thank you to my loved ones. I love you all. I'm so blessed.
Class of 2016, please stand. Please move your tassel from the left side and place it on the right.
Stop at the end of that.
Seniors may pick up their diplomas from Ms. Fletcher at Aspen Valley beginning at 1 o'clock. Thank you to the Board of Education, Ms. Bullock, and Dr. Hatchell. We would also like to send a special thanks to Lauren Ashley and Ms. Wasserman for the slideshow, and to Mr. Hamblin. Mr. Hamblin for the wonderful senior pictures used in the presentation.
And that concludes our ceremony. Underclassmen, you have about 10 minutes to socialize, and then it's back on the bus. We got more learning to do. Thank you very much.